ever calls him. Now, I have a question for all of you. One question unlike any other. A question that will make you reflect on the meaning of life and the universe as a whole. So, with all that being said, what the hell is this?
This is a Shashibo. It's a shape-shifting cube. Basically, they're like fidget spinners if they were actually good. These things right here, they can turn into over like 70 shapes. The creative possibilities are endless. Like here.
Look, it's a star. Now it's a crown. Now it's a ball. Now it's the divorce papers.
Like I said, these things are filled with creative possibilities. But going into that creative possibilities part, you don't need just one Shashibo in order to make some cool shapes. And that's what we're gonna do today. I'm gonna demonstrate both you and my friend on how to make some cool-ass shapes and some cool-ass Shashibos. What do you mean she's taking the kids?
All right, I'm in the separate room, and we have our guest today, Casey.
Hello.
Hi. You're gonna hold the camera for this while I present.
All right.
Today we're gonna make some cool shapes. This is what I did right here. I got all the Shashibo balls together and it made them into one cool shape. And it was kind of difficult. It was kind of hell even, but I managed.
What the hell? It broke.
This right here is a Shashibo.
Nice.
It's pretty square, I know. But this thing is more than just a square. It can shapeshift into different shapes right here. As you can see, we have a crown, and now we have a star.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. And if you tuck this little bit right in and turn it back into the crown, and you flip that inside out, I actually don't know what the shape names are. I'm just gonna make some up as we go along. And then we got this part right here, and if you squeeze it in, you get something like this. Kind of looks like an origami.
Yeah.
And we have a reverse origami, and if you flip that inside out, you get something like this right here. It's pretty neat.
Nice.
And if you tuck the pointer thing right in, looks like a cube that's trying to be tucked into a ball right here.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. And now if we resort back to the star shape, and if you put these little things inside out, you get something like this. It's an inside out cube right here.
Looks like the Triforce from Zelda.
Yeah, and you can also flip it inside out to make different kinds of these. Like you have this pattern right here, and now you have this one.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. And you can also flip this inside out thing inside out. If you go right here, you separate it and you tuck the little middle parts in, then you get something like this right here. Kind of looks like several different cubes at the same time. It's kind of like an optical illusion or something.
Yeah, it really is.
Mm-hmm. And if you squeeze that in right here, you're up right here. And
wow. Looks like a triangle on the inside there.
Mm-hmm. And yep. It's pretty neat and stuff.
Cool.
Mm-hmm. All right, if you flip it inside out again and just do something like this, you get the Shashibo ball right here instead of the cube.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm. Fun fact. You can put another cube inside of a ball right here. It kind of looks like a treasure chest. Yep, there we go. It's the Shashibo treasure thing. You have another Shashibo in it.
Oh, wow.
Mm-hmm. And then you have a... If you like squeeze it, you get something like this, like a snake or something. It
looks like an S or a Z.
Mm-hmm. And then you get the half ball. If you, if you push it in. And then if you open this part in and close this part, you get something like this.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. You can also do it inside out and such. And you get a shape like this. And if you open these triangle parts, you get something like this. And you can resort back to the Triforce thing.
Cool.
And if you flip over Baby's First Origami, and you have the snake part right here, you can open this and you get something like this. Kind of looks like a paper boat origami Baby's First thing. I don't know. And you have it look like a spaceship and like from Star Wars, if it was actually good. And
that's fire.
Mm-hmm. And you can also do an alternate version the same way you could do with the Triforce. You can open the Triforce and that and all that. And much like you can do this, you can also do the opposite with this thing right here. And you got this. And if you open the bottom part, you have this, and you got the... You got the triangle thing. I have no idea what these are called.
Like, almost looks like a 4D prism there.
Yeah, it does. And yeah, that's the basic combinations you have when you have a Shashibo. This one's pretty neat right here.
Oh, wow. Mm-hmm. Looks like one of those battle bots.
Yep. And you see this Triforce piece right here?
Yes, I do.
Yeah. Well, you can actually make several Shashibo combinations using, using more than one Shashibo. So if you take this and turn it to a Triforce thing, just let me take a second. There we go. You can actually combine these two together to make one whole unit right here.
Whoa.
Mm-hmm. It's pretty trippy. Looks psychedelic even.
Yeah.
Yeah. And let me grab those four black and white Shashibos right there. Alright, we have four Triforce pieces of the same cube, and we're gonna combine all of them to make one unit.
Wow.
We have the eight cube, or four cubes right here. We have four cubes.
Wow, that's cool.
Yep, and if you do it the other way around, you have a dome right here.
A what?
You have a dome, so you can put other Shashibos inside of it.
Nice.
Yep.
Well covered.
Next take. Okay. And if you flip the Triforce inside out, you get something like this. This right here.
What? That's an optical illusion and a half,
yeah.
Right there.
Yeah, it looks 60s Beatles psychedelic stuff. And if you do it inside out, so this is gonna be a hard one. And you can put other things inside of it. Let's move on to the next stage, see what you can do. Alright, so all you need right here is four Shashibo balls. And put them into the Shashibo prison hand thing, I don't know. Keep in mind, these things are magnetic, and so you might not be able to find all the magnetic, but... If you're able to get all of them magneted at once, You're a straight up god. Alright, you got these right here, and we're gonna take the Triforce pieces and put them right here, and we're gonna turn these into Triforce, and...
Wow. You're creating a Death Star here.
Yeah, Death Star if it was good.
Shots fired again, wow. Mm-hmm.
You got the Shashibo ball right here.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. One of many Shashibo ball variations, in fact. Did that not come out the right way? Yeah, there we go. Yeah. Okay, so let me introduce you guys to my favorite combination of Shashibos, and it's still part of the Shashibo ball thing. So you have to turn all your Shashibos into snakes right here, and three of them into Shashibo cakes. Like half a Shashibo ball or something. And you might want to stick like one little piece onto the left. Right, let me just do that. There we go. And you're gonna have to combine them all as a unit. That's how you do it. And then, cool. Then you do the same thing with the other half. Oh, wrong way. Did we tell this scripted? Okay, so you got this right here. And you got this. And you got this. We're gonna do the same thing right here. And we're gonna combine all these as a unit. And these are just simply there we go. You got this right here, and you're gonna have to move to the other way however you want. And we're gonna take a Shashibo snake. We're gonna make this little pattern right here, and then just slide it into this open space. And you basically have to do like this shape right here. Let me do it with the other one. And stuff. This is unscripted, so this might take a while.
Adjusting on the fly here.
Yeah. And one more.
Which way do you do it? There we go. Alright, so you basically have to do this right here on the same thing. And then you got the bottom part.
That is true.
You take matching shishibos. There we go. Take matching shishibos and put it inside of the open space. And do this. And make sure that you have it on this kind of shape right here. Mm-hmm. However you want. Or like however pattern you want it. I don't care. And you put them right here. So you got the first half done. And we're going to move on to the other half. We're going to take a bunch of other random shishibos. We're gonna put this one inside of this one right here. Let me just. All right, can you see clearly?
Yes, sir.
All right. So we're gonna do this shape right here, and then we're gonna slide that inside, and then just wrap around the other one. We're gonna do this two more times. Stop. No, there's the second one.
Wow.
And we're gonna have the final one right here.
It really is an optical illusion, isn't it?
Yeah. This one's kind of impossible to take down, actually. Alright. So, you're gonna do the same thing we did before. Take matching shishibos, put in a shishibo shape and all that, and put the one half right here, and where is it? There we go. And then you put the... Oh, wrong way. And then you put the other half right here. So here is the Shashibo Ball Complex Edition, or however you want to call it.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. It's pretty much impossible to take down. I made it so trippy, let's say.
Yeah, that's good.
Mm-hmm. And these leftover Shashibos, you can do whatever you want with them. Here's what I would do. I would turn this into the shape of like this right here. And then you do the same thing with the other Shashibo. We go. I did that all perfectly, and put that inside. You wrap it around, and there's some extra topping right here.
A little crown for it.
Yeah, it looks like a paper hat. Looks like paper bow.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah. So yeah, that's the Shashibo ball.
Cut. There it goes.
Okay, so for this next one, we're gonna need 6 half Shashibos, 5 Triforce pieces, 4 Shashibo balls. 3 inside-out Shashibos, 2, I don't know how to sing the Christmas song, and the partridge in a pear tree, I don't know. So we're going to take the first Triforce piece, we're going to lay it down, and we're going to look at the inside-out of the half Triforce, and we're going to, here we go, we're going to slide that in, kind of looks like one whole inside-out Triforce right here.
Looks like an Air Force One plane.
Yeah. And then we're gonna take the Triforce pieces. We're gonna put them in the. Actually, I made a mistake. We're supposed to have another inside out Triforce right here. And you put that right here, and it looks almost psychedelic. It's pretty much the same thing.
Yeah.
You have to add on. And then we're gonna take the balls. And then we're gonna put them on right here. And once again, these things, the magnetics for these things are hard to find, so yeah. And we're gonna place this one on top, and we're gonna take the half Shashibos. We're gonna do the same thing we did last time, where we take this and stick one out, except this time you're gonna do something like this. There we go, something like this. And so you got that, and we're gonna put the other side. It's basically like one, right on one side and left on the other, and we're gonna do the final side. There we go. We have the Shashibo UFO right here, or I don't know what it's called.
That's cool. Once again, very trippy.
Mm-hmm. And why are the magnets are so hard to find? This thing's kind of easy to take off and all that. It's like 4 different pieces, or 8 different pieces you can put on at once. Okay, so for the next one right here, we're gonna do Shashibo origamis right here. You probably learned that
a few minutes ago. And what we're going to do is we're going to make a Shashibo origami tower. So we're going to get these Shashibos and the origamis and stack them on one another. And you're going to have to alternate for this one a lot. Like at one moment, you have to do this one, and then the other, you have to do this one and whatnot. And we just got to stack them one another. Make sure all of them are origami. And since then, I don't have two more, we're just going to place these right here. Yeah, here it is right
here. Wow.
Mm-hmm. It's that's the trippy. Shashibo origami tower. It's pretty neat.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. You can do something like this right here as well.
And almost looks like a face.
Yeah. Oh god, I can't unsee that now. Oh. Get that away from me. Okay, so for this next state, we're gonna need 13 Triforces and 5 stars.
Oh god.
5 stars, but anyways, it doesn't really matter how many Shashibos you need. So far, what we have is like 18. You're probably gonna need more to make this one, since it's not even a complete shape, if you will, but whatever works. All right, so we're gonna do something similar to the 4 cube one, except you're gonna leave one completely blank and replace it with a star, and do something like this, and then grab the 2 Triforce pieces, and put them right here, and then the star right here, and then 2 Triforce, where is it, 1 star, and 2 Triforce, there it is, right. 1 star, 2 Triforce, 1 star, and 2 more Triforces right here. Here it is, right here.
Wow.
Yep, it's several Shashibo cubes all at once. It's still not completed. Like, it really could hurt if you had, like, one more Shashibo right here, but so far, it looks pretty good. There we go, now it looks pretty good. Alright, now on to the next one. Alright, so this one's a little bit of a short one right here, but for this one, you're gonna need 1 Triforce and 1... Inside Out Triforce. I keep forgetting the names. This isn't scripted. This part isn't scripted. So, anyways, for the Triforce, you have to bend one little star piece back right here. And for the Inside Out Triforce, you're gonna get one last little. You're gonna have this one point. And then you connect these ones together, you get something like this.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. It's pretty neat. And if you have 2 sticking out where it looks like a cube and Inside Triforce at the same time, and you got the Shashibo ball and with 1 sticking out, and if you shove these ones together, you get this.
Whoa, it's like a chair or something.
Yep. And also makes a thicker Shashibo right here. Granted, there are a lot of limitations for this. I can barely flip a lot of these like inside out and whatever. Like put one in this. Into here, like I can't even do it, but it's pretty good. And you can also close this and have this as a regular Shashibo ball. If you open it, you get a cube right here. And that's how you do it.
Yeah, nice.
Mm-hmm. All right. Next up, we're gonna have the grand finale. For this one, you're gonna need all the Shashibos as S shapes right here. And for this one, you're gonna kind of need a Shashibo cape for this. Except you're gonna stick the edges out right here to create sort of this shape right here. And then you place them down. And then you basically do the same thing with pretty much the rest. Okay, there we go. All right, we're just gonna do the same thing until it stops. Have our commentary while we're at it. So, anyways, how's your day?
My day's going pretty well. How about you, Everett?
I went to 7-Eleven today. There was no chicken.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, there's absolutely no chicken. I should sue 7-Eleven.
Whoa.
Except the Slurpees, though. They can stay.
Slurpees are good?
Mm-hmm. Oh, It's basically like you pretty much have to do the same way in order for this to work and whatnot.
Mm-hmm. Interesting. How's that divorce going?
It's going fine. She took the kids. Just living at my... been living at my friend's house as of late.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. I'm managing, though. That's the thing.
It's fair enough. Fine.
Life's been pretty distressing a lot since that divorce happened.
I feel that.
Yeah. I always get the wrong way.
Is that why your wife divorced you?
Yeah, pretty much. I treated divorce papers using Shashibos, and that's what led me here.
Fair enough, yes. Mm-hmm. The illegal combination of these guys.
Mm-hmm. It was quite tragic. It was a tragic day. She took the kids and whatnot. I just want to see little Jimmy again.
Little Jimmy?
Yeah, I named it after my favorite TV show. Jimmy Neutron.
Oh.
We're on the last phase right here.
It's hard to get all in the frame. Actually, it might be impossible.
Yeah. It's always the wrong way, gang. I'm still doing the wrong way. When will we get this right? I think that's why she left me. Okay, here it is right here. Here's the big tower of Shashibos. Yep, here it is. It's quite big, I'll say.
It really is.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, That's pretty much all the Shashibo combinations you can make with these ones. I don't mean like all of them, but the ones I'm going to introduce you guys for now. You might be able to find some cool new combinations in the future and whatnot.
Cool.
Yep. Should I knock this over or something?
Go for it.
Alright. There we go. It's knocked over. Am I allowed to make that joke? Would have been worse if there were two of them. I mean, cut the camera! And those are all the cool-ass shapes you can make using several Shashibos at once. The creative possibilities of these things are endless. You can make anything your heart desires with no limits. Like, legit, there's nothing stopping you from all these Shashibos and all that.